are blessed today? How many of you are blessed today? How many of you are blessed today? Hallelujah. Let's hear you say hallelujah.
Thank you.
it is at this time that we're going to pray for those that have special needs or special illness or whatever it may be. If you would like to come to the altar now, you may come. Or if you can just stand where you are. But it is the time to pray.
Thank you. Clarence and Catherine Miller from Alexandria, Virginia, members of the Alpha Three Baptist Church in Alexandria, Virginia.
Yeah, behind you.
Dr. Howard, Los Angeles, California.
And I'm Kimberly Jeffers, also from Los Angeles, California.
Give my praise to my heavenly Father. My name's Kimberly, I have the needs of my kids, and we don't have a church home, so we're here visiting my husband, Mr. Tino.
Amen.
Amen.
My name is Jenny Dunning, I'm visiting from RCC in Baltimore.
Yeah, thank you. On behalf of the Pastor Madison, the ministerial staff, and the St. Mark family, we're glad that you're here with us this morning. If this is your first or second Sunday with us, we are grateful that you have come to be with us this morning. It is our hope that you experience the love of Christ during our worship. We want to thank you for coming as well as standing. You may be seated. I'd like to share the following announcements. All college students are asked to turn in the necessary paperwork to determine scholarship eligibility by today. There will not be any extensions. Again, no extensions. Thank you in advance, Scholarship Committee. Galilee Bridge Memorial District Association of Baptist Church Zone 1 will be meeting today at New Jerusalem Institutional Baptist Church, where Pastor Ray Hines is the minister. Today, Sunday, August 31st at 3 o'clock p.m. The Real Men Cook will be held today after morning worship service in the Educational Center. Instead of the competition, the men will prepare and serve dinner to the congregation to show their appreciation for the spirit of cooperation. The next series of Wednesday night Bible spiritual growth classes have begun. The classes offered are Living Beyond Your Circumstances. Reverend Range acknowledges that life circumstances can be overwhelming. Let Hope In reassures that there is a sure hope for us, regardless of our past. And that is taught by Reverend Barry. Connected, My Life in the Church, a biblical understanding of what it means to be part of the body of Christ. And that teacher is Pastor Madison. Go ACES, Older Adults Still in Service, Senior Ministry will meet on Thursday, September 4th at 10 o'clock a.m. The men's ministry will meet on Monday, September 8th at 7 o'clock p.m. And the women's ministry will also meet every Monday, September 8th, September 15th, and September 22nd. St. Mark Missionary Baptist Church and New Friendship Missionary Baptist Church presents their annual tabletop brunch of elders, Saturday, September 13th, 2014, time 10 o'clock a.m. to 1 o'clock p.m. Tabletop viewing will be from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. And that will be at New Birth Baptist Church Jesus Center, 444 Ledbetter Drive, Dallas, Texas, 75224. Donation is $25. Tickets are still available from the Women's Ministry. If you plan to do a table, please see Sister Florence Madison, Sister Gloria Walker, or Sister Wanda Jackson. Food for thought. The Serenity Prayer. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and wisdom to know the difference. Living one day at a time, enjoying one moment at a time, accepting hardship as a path to peace, taking as he did the sinful world, as it is, not as I would have it, trusting that he would make all things right if I surrender to his will, that I may be reasonably happy in this life and supremely happy with him forever in the next. Amen. Everybody have a blessed week.
Thank you, Sister. We will now have a special presentation by our Thank You, Lord, praise team.
Thank you.
saw the dust in me. When everyone else around could only see the worst in me. Can I tell y'all one more time? I said he saw the best in me. When everyone else around could only see the worst in me. I wish I had a witness tonight. All I need is one. Yeah.
He saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me,
Madison, sick. It's your hand.
Junior. I know that one of a lot of you are here, but Brother Gilson, Brother Henry, and Brother Miller, they can comprehend that because they're of that era. But nevertheless, that was good. I looked around the church today. This being Labor Day, I'm reminded that churches in Oklahoma and the churches in Louisiana are filled today. Some of you all don't know what that means. They've got some of those churches in Las Vegas. And I know that our members are praying on to get tithes and offerings to bring back home. Amen. Yes. Also, let me just do this quickly. There was a teenager that's always present in church, served faithfully down through the years. And this teenager had a birthday this week. Sister Lipson. She has turned, I believe it's 18 today. Yeah. Now you can do the reverse of that. But nevertheless, we thank and praise God, our Father, for her and her faithfulness in this church. Amen. And Sister Henry here today, there she is. Understand that you have a love relationship that's going to be beginning here with your knee surgery, with your doctor. Amen. Oh, you didn't love your... But nevertheless, we wanted you to know that we will be praying for you, and hopefully when that's rescheduled, let us know, and we'll be there to lend our support to you and have prayer with you and your husband, Brother Henry. Is Brother Henry here today?
Yes, sir.
There he is. You know one thing about Brother Henry, wherever you see him, you'll know who he is. He has a smile as tough as a rubber band. Amen. And also, I'm pleased to see the lineage of our family here today, the Giles family, that's visiting here with us today during the family reunion this week. And we're so pleased that God has allowed them to come together one more time to share in the love relationship of kindred that binds our hearts together. And we want them to know that we are grateful and thankful that you all are here worshiping with us here today. Amen?
Amen.
As I said on last night, that's tweeters, Texans, emails, telephones, that should keep us together week by week. And we should not let a week go by without saying, hello, how you doing? And that's a good way to keep the fellowship together. And that's a way to let those who are coming up behind us know exactly who they are and who we are, so that they can keep their longevity together of relationship one with the other. Amen?
Amen?
And we want to thank the women's chorus for braving the storm today.
Amen.
Amen. And during normal worshiping hours rather than holidays, they fill the choir stand. But the faithful few are here.
Amen.
Amen.
And we thank and praise God for that. And sometimes you can't read your own writing. Today is Zone Board's Day, and you all have been so faithful in supporting me as the Zone Chairperson of District, and I appreciate that. And if you can, I know this is a weekend, but if you can, let's be there to support the whole Zone. Amen? Your attendance is vitally necessary. And the men today, this was to be the cook-off. We usually have each year a cook-off between the men of the church to see who can do the best cooking. Is that right? So since the men won't be able to campaign for that dish today, and you are going to be recipients of that dish, I want to thank them for what efforts they have put together to make sure that they show love to all of you. And we want... Now, please understand, these fellas can't cook now. They can cook.
Oh, yeah.
So I want you all to appreciate the hospitality from them today. I want you to eat up everything, and if you want to get mad, tell them to go get some more. Amen?
No.
All right. This week, Sister Madison and I, Brother Turner and his wife, will be traveling to New Orleans for the National Baptist Convention. And we ask your prayers.
Amen.
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 We ask your prayers for our safe return. And most of all, we ask that you would be in prayer, because this is an election year. And we would like to have the best man God has available to step into the position of leadership and responsibility. And I always say, position without accountability is just a wasted position. No vision, no movement. No movement, no stir. Amen? So let's be in prayer for that. And today we have with us Sister Adams, who will be our Women's Day speaker. And she pastors in Gala. Amen. She's a product of the house. Some of y'all call it the Potter's House. But she's a product of Arkansas. Raised in the little tiny woods in Arkansas, and I met her at one of the services in our chapel that she did, and I was very moved to have her to come and share with us here today. And we're going to have her get out of the way so she can get back to her congregation today, and we'll be praying for her. And I ask each of you to be in prayer for her as she stands today and provide us with what the Lord has given her. Amen? And again, St. Lord, thank all of you very much for your coming today, because I know a lot of you could have been sharing this nice sunny day in one of the churches in Ohio, one of the churches in Louisiana and Oklahoma with some of the rest of the members. Amen?
My bad. Now we're gonna have an introduction of the speaker by Sister Dickerson. I'm gonna have to pull this back out now.
Okay. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm giving honor and praise to my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I am to introduce our speaker. We're going to do the second part, pass the first part. Good morning, Pastor Mavis Adams. Pastor Apostle Mavis Adams serves as the senior pastor and founder of Restoration Triumph Church in Garland, Texas, for the past 12 years. She is the spiritual daughter of Bishop T.D. Jakes, and her ministry is covered in the Potter's House International Pastoral Alliance. She is a writer, a teacher, entrepreneur, and has appeared twice on TBN's Praise the Lord show. What a blessing. In the past, she worked in proprietary education for 29 years, served as a college president, regional director, director of marketing and admissions, bringing focus and direction in career advancement for many lives. Pastor Mavis has a passion for wisdom, miracles, the favor of God, prayer, growth, and development, and helping others excel and be their very best. She is known as the Praying Apostle and believes that the living God hears our every word and that our words have weight in the spiritual realm, and we are anointed to win the battle because we are chosen to win. After the singing of the morning hymn, I present to you Pastor Apostle Mavis Adams. Thank you and God bless.
Thank you. Let's give the Lord a hand praise and mark. Let everything that hath breath praise ye the Lord. Just turn around to two or three people this morning and tell them they're looking good this morning. Yeah, let them know they're looking good. They got up and put on their Sunday best. Amen. You're looking good this morning. Amen. To God our Father. Amen. That feels, it feels more like church. Amen. Amen. Loosen up and let God have his way. Hallelujah. We first of all want to give honor to the man of God and the woman of God that served him, Pastor Alan Madison and his lovely wife. Can you thank God for the shepherd of this house for, I understand, over 30 years, amen, that he has been laboring in the vineyard here at St. Mark. We want to thank God for all of the ministers here, the deacons, our ushers. Let's thank God for our ushers this morning. Amen. Also, Brother Turner, I'm sorry, Sister Turner. I was trying to say Brother Barry, who's helped me this morning. Sister Turner, let's thank God for her. Our program chair, amen. I understand that she labors and works on at every committee, at every program. Also, the women's president, Sister Gloria Walker. Let's thank God for her. And the vice president, Sister Wanda, I believe, Jackson, if I have the name correct. Amen. Let's thank God for them. Amen. Is there any church mothers? And I understand the birthday lady. Let's thank God for her. Amen. Amen. And all of our musicians and the choir. We just want to thank God for everybody. And you too. God is here. Just before we get started, I just looked out, Pastor, and I saw a few of my members that came along this morning. Amen. Amen. We had to leave somehow. You know, you can't bring everybody. Amen. But a few that pressed their way, and I'm going to ask Sister Jane Dunnigan. You may know this young lady and her children to stand up if they would. Amen. And anybody else in our church, amen, that came. She went to Dallas Funeral Institute. She's a graduate as well. Amen. Amen. Let's thank God, amen, for them that they came this morning to support their pastor. So we're excited, amen. Sister Turner, could you bring that up for me? I just want to make a quick presentation if I could. This is something that God gave me on July 3rd, and he wanted me to give the first one to Pastor Madison this morning. And he actually heard me read it at the homegoing celebration we had at the church. And it's a poem God gave me entitled Remember. God gave this to me. As you go, remember that God is faithful. Life is about learning. Faith is about reaching. Love is about giving. Honor is about respecting. Peace keeps you settled. Focusing keeps you on target. Worshiping keeps you open. Reading takes you places. Kindness multiplies back to you. Your choices determines your environment. Believing keeps you moving. Trusting in God gives new life. Exposure gives new opportunities. Being whole comes from the Master. Patience is a beautiful rhythm. Forgiving extends your life. Thankfulness is the seed for more. Remember where you came from. It will help keep you grounded. Help someone and show the Father's love. Be humble in front of people and be humble in front of God. It will take you a long way in the kingdom. As you go, remember as you go. And it's signed to Pastor Alan G. Madison, Love Beyond Measure, Apostle Mavis Adams. Amen. We have a few more of those. If you'd like to get one, purchase one over in the fellowship hall. And we have some of our product of the sermon. We have those as well. But I want to present the first one to him. Amen. If you have your Bible this morning, in our church we usually declare a covenant of peace before we begin. Again, I meant to bring it to read it, but I'm just going to say Jesus is the Prince of Peace. Amen. We declare that there will be peace in this house. And how many know when there's peace in the house, miracles can flow? Because we're all on one accord. So turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, let there be peace in this house. Let there be unity in this house. And let the miracle of God happen today. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. If you would, get your Bibles and turn with us to a very familiar scripture. We want to do, some of you may know it from home. I may have a couple other scriptures that you do, so I'm asking to keep your sword handy so that you can turn to it quickly. John 3:16. Amen. We're going to work with it just like the committee has it. Amen. I'm going to ask if you would, when you have it, if you would stand to your feet for the reading of the word. How many know in Jesus' day, they stood for the reading of the word? I ask that we can do the same, to show honor. How many know that one of the greatest seeds you can sow is the seed of honor? Honor thy father and mother.
Yeah.
So that thy days may be what? Long. Do you have it?
Yes.
Someone beside you doesn't have a Bible, let them look on with you. John 3:16. Are you ready?
Yes.
I want us to read it together if we would. Can someone get me a Kleenex quick? John 3:16. John 3:16. Let us read together. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Can we read it one more time? I want you to read it this time like you really believe it. Amen. You ready? All right. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And for a few moments, we're going to talk from the subject. Just turn to someone and help minister. If you would, we're going to talk from the subject they gave us. Just turn to someone and say, neighbor, what we're going to talk about today is love beyond measure. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Speak to us, O God, only as you can speak. Father, give me nimbleness of thought, nimbleness of mind, agility of wit, O God, to speak to these your people. Holy Spirit, move as you've never moved before. Father, let somebody get a miracle this morning of healing in their body. Let somebody be delivered this morning. Let somebody be convicted, converted, and changed. Father, I thank you today that we will never be the same. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I just want to get everybody to say amen together so I can see how it's going to sound.
Amen.
That sounds pretty good. All right. Love beyond measure. In the first part of John, the third chapter, Nicodemus has just finished talking to Jesus about, what must I do to be saved? Nicodemus goes to Jesus at night to ask him a question that will bring him out of the darkness into the marvelous light. The Bible says in Proverbs, "In all thy getting, get an understanding." And Nicodemus is trying to use his mind to see, what must I do to be saved? He's trying to wrap his mind around the question, how can I be born again? And I stopped by to tell you this morning, even though Nicodemus was using his mind to try to figure out what was missing in his life, you need to use your mind to try to figure out, what must I do to get it right with God?
Yeah.
He uses his mind. I think they have a saying that says a mind is what? A terrible thing to waste. And Nicodemus is trying to understand the mysteries of the kingdom. Isn't it interesting that the Bible says it is with the mind that I serve the Lord? And how many know you can't do nothing unless your mind is fixed right? I believe the old people wrote a song that says, I woke up this morning with my mind stayed on Jesus. And I mean, they wouldn't stop there with that. They would stop walking and talking with my mind stayed on Jesus. And the old people used to say, Lord, help my mind. I remember there was a lady that we grew up with, her name was Miss Effie. And Miss Effie's prayer used to be, Lord, keep me in my right mind. She didn't ever want to lose her mind because she understood how important it was. And I know that God answered that prayer for her. She was almost 100 years old and could tell you the name of everybody who walked in the door. Because her confession was, Lord, keep me in my right mind. Just touch your mind right now and say, Lord, keep me in my right mind. Keep me in my right mind. Keep me in my right mind. Keep my thoughts straight. Keep my focus straight. Keep me in my right mind. Don't let any disease or anything from the enemy attack me. Because what happens in your mind determines what you do next. Hallelujah. It's with your mind that determines what your belief system is. Somebody say belief. See, you can believe your way into something, or you can believe your way out of something. It's what you believe determines whether or not you are successful. It's who you believe that determines whether or not you get a promotion. Oh, I need you to think about that for a minute. Who you believe. If you believe your boss, if you don't believe that your boss said if you show up 15 minutes late again, you're going to get fired. It's who you believe. Who you believe that determines whether or not you're going to get promoted. And it's why you believe that lets us know whether or not your heart is in the right place. Why you believe. Why do you believe you should be saved? Why do you believe you should be living? Why do you believe? When you look at the word love, love means, according to Webster's, a strong affection or attachment to someone. A strong liking or an interest in someone to take great or intense pleasure or emotions in. But when you look at 1 Corinthians 13:4, in the NIV, it says this about love. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy and it does not boast. Love is not proud. It is not rude. Somebody said not rude. It is not self-seeking, and it is not easily angered. And listen what it also says about love. Love keeps no records of wrong. Right. Turn to your neighbor and say, do you have any records? Ah. Some of us can't remember nothing, but it depends on what it is. We can tell you the day and hour. Tell your neighbor, say, what kind of records you got? I'm not going to touch that this morning. Amen. Love does not delight in evil, but it rejoices in the truth. Love, it always protects. Somebody say always. It always trusts. It always trusts. It always hopes. It always perseveres. Love never fails. Now the question is, what does always mean? Always means, listen to this, at all times. I looked it up. At all times and on all occasions. So that means if I always trust, I always hope, I always persevere, there should not ever be a time that I give up on love. Turn to your neighbor and say, don't give up on love. I want to read it to you out of the Message translation. Can I read it to you out of the Message? Now listen to this. Make it a little plain. Love never gives up. Love cares more for others than for self. Love doesn't want what it doesn't have. Love doesn't strut. Doesn't have a swelled head. Doesn't force itself on others. It isn't always me first. Listen to this. Love doesn't fly off the handle. Love doesn't keep score of the sins of others. Love revels when others grovel. It takes pleasure in the flowering of truth. Love puts up with anything. Trust God always. Always looks for the best. Never looks back, but keeps going on to the end. Love never dies. How many of you know we need to wrap our mind around that? Turn to your neighbor and say, do you love like that? Amen. I think Tina Turner wrote a song. What did she say? What love? Got to do with it. Amen. Amen. I want you to turn, if you would, to, I want two scriptures I want you to turn to. John 4, 7 through 8. I just want to give you a real picture of love. After our First John 4. I want you to see a real picture of love. Amen. Are you getting anything? All right. 1 John 4:7-8. Are you there?
Yes.
Beloved, let us love one another. For love is of God. And everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. He that loveth what? Not knoweth. Loveth not. Knoweth what? Not God. For God is what?
Love.
Now that's the greatest picture of love you could ever have. For God is love. Now turn to Malachi 3:16. This is the last one I want you to look at. I want you to have a real good understanding of love. Malachi 3:16. And this is what we're supposed to love like. Amen? Malachi 3:16. Now, I'm going to have a reason, but... Amen. All right. Y'all ready? All right. Somebody stand up and read that for me. A good reading. Come on.
Those
who fear the Lord talk with each other. Uh-huh. And the Lord listened and heard. Uh-huh.
A scroll of remembrance
was
written in his presence concerning those who fear the Lord and honor his name.
Okay, so you can't say that you love me and you don't talk to me. Oh. It said, and then those that fear the Lord spake often to one another. You didn't hear that. If you fear the Lord, you will speak to people. You will speak to the sister on the others. Y'all gonna make me work this morning. I see that now. You will speak to the person on the other side of the church. You speak to your neighbor. You speak to the people that you can't stand. If you fear the Lord, you will speak to people. And then it says down to that, but the Lord listened to him. Turn to your neighbor and say, God is listening. Not only is he listening, he has them with a book writing down whether or not you spoke to Nancy. Did you speak to Jimmy? Did you speak to Miss Willie? Or did you speak to Johnny the alcoholic? Are y'all gonna make me work this morning? Did you speak to Willie the wino? Did you speak to Mary that don't never take a bath? Did you speak to? It says he looked, he listened, and he remembered. Somebody say, God, remember. All right, let's deal with this thing. When you look at the word beyond, listen, beyond means on or on the far side of. Somebody say far side of. When it's beyond, it's outside the reach or understanding of. It's farther away. Somebody say farther away. Life is about discovery. And some of our greatest problems or challenges occur when we can't get beyond something. When we can't get beyond something. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, what is it you can't get beyond? You can't get beyond who did it, who said it, how they said it, how they look. You can't get beyond. They didn't use your cookies, they used somebody else's cookies. You can't get beyond it. They didn't call your name this Sunday, but they called Sister Such and Such's name last Sunday. This is your thing. Love for you. Magic. The good news is that you can get beyond anything. You can get beyond misunderstandings. You can get beyond loneliness. You can get beyond worry. You can get beyond frustration. You can get beyond mean looks. Somebody say, get beyond that. I can prove to you that you can get beyond that. When Jesus went to Calvary, he went beyond death, hell, and the grave. When Jesus went to Calvary, he went beyond folk talking about him, folk lying on him, to prove to you that you can get beyond it. When Lazarus was in the grave, Jesus said, Lazarus come forth. Lazarus got beyond sickness, disease. He got beyond grave clothes being wrapped up on him. He got beyond being dead for a day, and he came forth. You can get beyond that. You can get beyond that. You can get beyond criticism. You can get beyond that. I stopped by to tell you this morning that your miracle is just around the corner. Tell your neighbor, say, my miracle is around the corner. It's around the corner. I can get beyond that. I can get beyond that. I can get beyond that. This is a word for somebody this morning. I can get beyond that. You can get beyond that. Who laughed at your kid? Who talked about your kid? You can get beyond who didn't hire you. You can get beyond that. Your next business opportunity is on the other side of what you can get beyond. When Jesus was with his disciples, he would always prophesy his way out of situations. And he would say, let us go over to the other side. And then the Bible records that they came over to the other side. He would prophesy that we're going to get beyond people trying to kill me, stab me. We're going to get beyond this. Hallelujah. What are you willing to sacrifice to get to the next level? When you look at the word measure, it means extent, dimension, capacity, especially as determined by standard. Measuring cups here. Can y'all see these in the back? Folk try to measure you up. Because they want to know how you got what you got. They want to know, how did you qualify for that? They want to know, how did you get the car you got, the house you got? How did your kids get in the school that you got? You didn't go past the sixth grade, but now your child got a PhD. They want to know, how did you measure up to that? This is people's standards. Y'all with me? This is people's standards. But this is not a God standard. I have a great aunt, Pastor Madison, a great aunt. She's gone on to be with God. And what I discovered is she was a really good cook. I want y'all to hear this. She was a really good cook. She could bake everything. Matter of fact, she got cancer the first time when I was little. And I was crying because I was like, Lord, who gonna make the dressing? You can take a nap. But I ain't had enough dressing. People would come from miles around. They would follow my brother's home. If they knew that she was going, they would go into her house just so they could eat some dressing. Because they knew she was gonna have, she was a good cook, she could cook anything. Pie, cake, you name it. But the one thing I noticed about my great aunt cooking was that when she cooked, she never used. Come on here. She never used measuring cups.
Say your word.
She had cookbooks, but she never used a measuring cup. And she could make some of the best apple pie. She made a banana cake. It was a three layer, like yellow cake with banana filling in each level. The banana filling would be warm. And she could make my favorite, a German chocolate cake from scratch. And then she could make a four layer, come on here, I see you, brother, a four layer chocolate cake. And then you got some dressing, and she could take a steak and make it so tender that when you put the fork, it would just the steak will come loose. She would have a little sesame seeds in there. Come on, it would be so good. I would just sit there and just eat till I was full because she was a good cook. But one thing I discovered, she never used measuring cups. And the Holy Spirit spoke and said this to me. He said, neighbors, some of my best works are done that you can't measure. Oh, you can't touch this. When Jesus had two fish and five loaves and fed 5,000, you couldn't measure. When the woman with the issue of blood touched the hem of his garment, no medical book had ever recorded that before. You can't measure. His ways, his thoughts are so high, and his love of me is so great, you can't measure it. The seas are so wide, come on somebody, that you can't measure it. This is how you know it's God and not man when you can't measure it. I don't know why he loves me. I don't know why he cares for me. I don't know why one drop of blood when Jesus died on Calvary made dead men get up out of the ground and walk back. You can't measure. His love for me is beyond measure. I don't know why he could take mud and put it on a blind man's eyes who had been blind from birth and the man could see. You can't measure that. Some of the greatest things God did, you can't measure it. Oh yeah, MC Hammer was on to something. You can't touch it. Jesus was anointed to remove burdens and destroy yokes. He could speak and the dead would get up out of the grave. He could speak and he slayed a tornado and said, peace, be still. You can't measure that. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He could take water and turn it into wine. You can't measure that. His love is beyond measure. But I'm telling you, people walk around. How you got where you got. They want to measure how you got a PhD, but you never, how your Dr. Maya Angelou never went to college, but she had more than 65 honorary PhD degrees when she got. You can't measure that. Not only did she have the degrees, but when she opened up her mouth, she had some knowledge and some faith. It's one thing to have the degree. Oh God, come up here. And be without understanding. She had the degree. This is what the Holy Spirit said to me. I want you to listen to this. The Holy Spirit said to me, he said, Mavis, I want you to tell the people. The reason why people want to try to measure you is because anything that you measure, you can control. Yeah. If I can measure, I can control it. I can tell you what time to get up and what time to go to bed. If I can measure it. But if your God is in the middle, your testimony is, I don't know why Jesus did what he did. I don't know how I got where I got. Pastor God called me off of a job 4 years ago. When I say called off, I mean off the job. I'm still standing, y'all, 4 years. Come on, somebody. Come on, that's God. You can't measure. I can't tell you how I got money in my bank account. I can't measure how my bills got paid. I can't measure the favor that God gave me. I can't measure what he's done for me. He's done so much for me. And I cannot tell it all. What he's done for me. I cannot tell it all. I wasn't going to go this way, but God is leading me to go this way. Now listen, let me share this with you. God had me to get into 40 days of prayer. Anytime you do something for 40 days, God honors 40 days. But before he led me to 40 days of prayer, he led me to a 4-day fast. The number 4, hear me? 40 days of prayer. 4-day fast. And I was talking to a guy that's sitting right beside my church as a preacher from, he's an overseer from Chicago. And God sent him down from Chicago, and he just said to me, we were talking, he said, you need more power. And I said, I'm cold turkey. I went on a fast from that very moment. I didn't touch nothing else for 4 days. I began to focus on God. And I began to pray. And I'm not talking about play praying. How many of you know some people play praying? No. I'm talking about it was intense prayer. We had it twice a day at 2 and at 7. And sometimes I would be there for 2.5 hours. And some people would come meet me and I would be praying. Because prayer really does. How many of you know? I just want to see a show of hands of how many of you are sick. Anybody who's sick, got any kind of pain? I just want to see. Yeah. Hold your hands high. Jesus is looking. Yeah. Hey, he knows. He already knows. You can't measure what he knows. How many know the government can try to get on the internet and measure your business? But once I have a little talk with Jesus, oh, come on, somebody. And I tell him all about my trouble. They can't measure the results that I get. So listen, I just want to see how many sick. I don't know what I'm supposed to do with that, but just hold that thought. So I begin to pray. First day, second day, 12th day, and I send out text messages. But I want you to know, I'm trying to raise your faith. How many want your faith to go to another level? Oh God. Oh God. Let's do it again so heaven can see. Let's raise your hands again. Amen, that you want your faith to go to another level. Touch somebody. I need you to touch somebody right now. Somebody add my faith to you. Just add my faith to you. Touch 2 or 3 people. Yeah, because 1 will put 1,000 to flight. 2 will put 10,000 to flight. Your faith to go to another level. It was on the 12th day that God gave me to pray for government. And I was praying for government. And I began to pray for the church. And I began to put up firewalls and fire shields for protection. And I began to put up firewalls and fire shields around our schools to protect our children.
Yeah.
And I began to put up firewalls and fire shields around the airports. and around the airplanes and the buses and everywhere that they had been wrecking havoc. And then I put up firewalls and fire shields around our whole church property. I put up firewalls and fire shields around the United States. And as I spoke that, somebody said spoke that, I saw literally little torches going around the United States. Oh, I wish somebody got hurt. How many know what you have what you say? And so then I began to speak firewalls and fire shields around Jerusalem. And then I put up firewalls and fire shields around Israel. And when I said Jerusalem, I heard a sound go. I'm trying to describe it to you. How many of you have ever hit a little gas stove? You know what that sounds like. How many of you ever hit, if you ever lit one and you know those gas stoves, that's what it sounded like. And I looked down at my feet and I noticed my feet started to soak because I was moving at a frantic pace. I was sweating like crazy. And I was moving at a frantic pace. I noticed my steps started to slow, but I didn't understand why. And then when I said firewalls and fire shields around Israel, I heard a sound that sounded like large flags blowing. How many of y'all know large flags? Are like all your windows in a car are rolled down. And when I said Jerusalem, listen to me, this is when it happened. This is when it happened. Fire literally fell from heaven. I was on fire. I'm not talking about like jumping like the Holy Ghost fire. I'm talking about I was lit with fire. It went from my ankles all the way up. I'm trying to challenge your faith this morning. Maybe you've never heard, help Holy Ghost. But I was literally on fire. How many know that Elijah called down fire? Yeah. I experienced this. And not only that, when I extended my hands, flames were shooting up on both sides of my arms, 10 inches in the air. And I stood there. How many know it ain't nothing else to pray after that? I closed up my Bible. I turned the lights out. I locked the door. It is nope. Prayer is dismissed. But I want you to know this. It took me 3 weeks to cool down. Not just now. And it took me another 3 weeks to cool off. I couldn't hardly wear clothes. Even this was too light. This was too hot on my body. I couldn't do anything. I'm talking about taking your faith to another level. We serve a God that loves us so much that he'll answer by fire. He'll answer. Come on, come on, come on. Shake your mind. Get your mind around. Have you read about the burning bush? You read about the bush. I was the bush. And I burned. And I said, God, what am I supposed to tell the people? You can do anything. You love us beyond measure. He sent Jesus to die for us.
Can you
I didn't lose you on that, did I? I didn't lose you, did I? All right, I just want to make sure I still got you. CPR, if we need to do CPR on somebody give it. He loves us so much that he'll do whatever we have to do to get to the next level. I'm just going to stop right here with that. I was going to tell you, well, I'll go ahead. Let me just pull this out. For God so loves the world. It's not just love, but listen, it's so love. You can't measure that. Come on, somebody. He's so loved. You can't measure that. That he gave. Love is giving. Love is giving. Have you given something to your pastor lately? Oh, I know I'm Melly now. Have you given something to your husband or wife lately? Have you given? Have you just said, Pastor, I want to bless you with this. I want to sow a seed of honor. Let me tell you something. When you sow a seed of honor to the man or woman of God, God blesses you beyond measure.
That's the book.
That he gave his what? Only. Now, what have we been taught? We have been taught, don't ask nobody for their last. But God does what? He gives his what?
All.
I want that to soak in. The little boy only had two fish, five loaves. The widow only had two mice. Touch your neck and say, only is enough.
Only is enough.
It's enough. It's enough. Oh, yeah, Pastor, give it. The folk that's not here today, God is going to show faithfulness. You're going to raise more today than tithes and offerings. Come on, somebody. You're going to raise. I'm not going to take it up, but somebody's been stirred and convicted. I need to know, who needs a miracle from God? Come on, if you need a miracle, I want you to stand up. Let's stand up if you need a miracle. Touch your neighbor and say, I agree. Yeah, I agree with you. Touch him. If anyone agrees, touch him. I agree with you for your miracle. We serve a God. The Holy Spirit said something to me the other day. It was so profound, I almost missed it. God is God. All that bill money. Pastor, I don't know when you're supposed to take it up, but all your bill money, I'm going to challenge you today. Give God the tithe. You owe him that. But I'm going to challenge you today to go in your bill money. I did it. I'm not going to ask you to do nothing I haven't done. I got to share this. When my husband had left me. Okay, God has sent me. When my husband had left me, a woman of God came and husband came down from Chicago. He left me, I had all the bills. How many know that you get left with everything? They need a dog. Come on here. All he had was his little suitcase. They need a bill, they need everything. Just wiggle your big toes, nobody will know it but you. If you haven't been there, they need everything. Yeah, play that song, that is minister. And I want you to listen. The woman of God said, she had preached the mighty word. We had already taken up an offering before she got there. And she said, God has said, sow a $77 seed. And he's going to answer in 90 days. Do you hear me? Someone say $77. 90 days. Dig. Keep digging. Some of you are already working. Holy Spirit is already moving. Work in faith. Touch somebody and say, work in faith. So I got up. All I had was my car payment. Do you hear me? Some of you going right now, all I got. That's enough. That's enough. All you need is seed. That's enough. If you have faith, the side of mustard seed. All you need is some seed. See, I grew up in the country, so I know what a package of seed would do. Oh, y'all get that later, huh? And I was sharing with them, I had asked Mother Jane the other day, I said, how do you get some good watermelons for next year? How do you do that? And she knew the answers. She said, the watermelon that tastes the best and tastes the sweetest, you save those seeds. And you plant those next year. So in other words, those seeds that you save by that good watermelon, those are the best seeds. Oh, y'all didn't hear what I just said. See, if you want God to move, you got to give him your best seed. Oh, God. You got to give him your best. You know what I'm talking about. Country people in here know something about plants. You gotta give them your best seed. Not what's left, your best seed. And it'll be some good watermelon. I love yellow leaf watermelon. You give them your best. So I got up in the line. And I sold the $77 seed. And I said, God, I trust you. Do anybody in here trust God? I know you trust. Come on here, don't trust a TSU more than you trust God. Don't trust food stamps more than you trust God. And I sold the $77 seed. And somewhere on day 45, I took out a calendar and I started counting. I said, the woman of God said, this seed is on me. Come back in 90 days. It was prophecy over that seed. I believe. Because it's who you believe that determines whether or not you get a promotion. What you believe. Are you with me?
Yeah.
I sowed that seed. Day 45. Meanwhile, my aunt, some months earlier, back during tax time, had died in Colorado and had left me a house. And at that time, you weren't hardly getting any money for your house. And it was tax time, and the realtor laughed at me. He said, you ought to put it on the house now. People got their taxes. But something in me wouldn't let me put the house on the market. But doing that, listen to this, the week of the 90 days, God told me to call the realtor and put the house on the market. And I called him, I said, put it on the market. He said, but how much? I said, for the full asking price. He said, you're not going to get it. I said, put it on there for the whole full asking price. You'll never get it, is what he said to me. He shouldn't have never said no. Full asking price. Put it on the market. During that seventh day of the 90-day week, the house sold for $77,000. Come on, somebody. You can thank God better than that. I sold a $77 seat and got a 1,000-fold return during the week of the 90 days. And guess what? My husband was gone. He didn't get no money either. You got to be present and accounted for. What did you say about accountability, Pastor? He had vision to leave. I had vision to stay. We both had vision. But I'm still in the house and he left. Trust God this morning. That's, I don't know if it's time for tithes and offerings, but trust God this morning. Write the biggest check you ever wrote. Write it. God loves you enough to cover the check.
Yeah.
He loves you enough. He sent Jesus all the way to Calvary so that you would have an opportunity to prove his faithfulness. Any faithful people in the choir this morning? Do you have faith? Do you have faith? God is going to do something in this house today that is beyond measure. And I know we got some wealthy people in this house. You may have to move something around because you didn't plan on doing it. But you need to move something around. Turn your neighbor and say, shift. How do you know somebody driving a 5-speed? Come on, when you get ready to get to that 5th gear, come on, do that. Shift. I'm shifting in the spirit. Come on, shift in the spirit. I'm not going to stay here. Come on, I need you to do it. Y'all ain't doing it. Come on, shift. All right, here. I need you, brother. Come on. I need you to shift, brother. Come on. Shift. That's it. See, we're going to have unity today. You're going to get your best miracle today. That's what you want me on the door when you're with us. If you've never accepted Jesus Christ into your heart as your personal Savior, won't you come? But if you've accepted him and your faith has shifted to a new level today, I want those people to come on my right. If your faith has shifted to a new level today, if you believe in God to do, I want you to come on your right, on my right. If you backslid and you got away from God, so God is going to do it today. He wouldn't send me over here if he wasn't going to do it. Maybe you want to rededicate your life back to God and say, God, I didn't know you loved me like that. I understand now that your love for me is beyond measure. I know you think grandma loves you and grandpa loves you, but don't nobody love you like God. Love you like God. He loved you so much that he gave you your own fingerprint. Nobody in the world has your fingerprint. He loves you so much that he took time out to say, Elon, so thank you, God. My God. He loved you so much that he went to the garden and prayed for us. The Bible says he prayed for us that our faith wouldn't fail. Would you check around and see if anyone needs to come? Ask. I need you to work. I need you to work. Ask them, are you saved? Are you looking for a mirror? Ask, I need you to work. Talk to the people. Talk to the people around. I need you to work. If your faith came to a new level today, I want to pray for you. I want you to come stand. If your faith has shifted to a new level, I want to pray for you before I turn the mic on. If your faith has shifted to a new level, it's a testimony to the goodness of God. Don't let people measure your faith. You're not going to let Satan limit you. Come on, let's thank God. Don't let Satan limit you. You ought to have a faith that can't be limited. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, God. I know it's someone else. Come on, move, move. Holy Spirit, move. Convict, convict. Do it, God. Do it, God. The man and woman of God have been faithful here for 30 years. Do it, God. Do it, God. Do it, God. I need you praying, church. I need you praying, church. Move, Holy Spirit. Move, Holy Spirit. Move, Holy Spirit. Move, Holy Spirit. Oh, I feel your presence. I feel your presence. God is here. 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 There's somebody in the back. If your faith is shifted, I need you to move. Don't ask for a miracle and not move when it's time. The man that laid in the pool 38 years missed his miracle because he wouldn't move. You got to move. You got to move. Heaven is watching you move. You got to move. Heaven is watching you move. If you need a miracle in your finances, you need to move. You need to come. If you need a miracle in your marriage, you need to come. You need a miracle in your relationship. You need your college tuition paid for. You need to come. You need your home restored. You need to come. You know you have been loving like you should. You need to come. You need to come. You need to come. Come on, come on, saint. Thank you, Father. 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 You have sickness in your body. The doctor has told you he doesn't know what to do. You need to come. You need to come to Dr. Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. There should be a child here that should be moving in faith. I don't know who you are, but there's a child today that needs to move in faith. I don't know who you are. Move in faith. I don't know if your home is broken up and your dad's not in the home or mom's not in the home. I don't know if your parents are addicted, but you need to come. You need to come. And maybe you've been here today and you were addicted on drugs. You were addicted on crack. But nobody knows. You need to come. You need to come. You need to come. Miracles. Miracles, God. Do miracles. Do miracles. I feel a release of my spirit, Pastor. I feel a release of my spirit. Sing that song, I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you, Lord.
Some of the best things that God has, you can't measure. You can't measure it. You can't measure what He wants to do for you. You can't measure it. Stop trying to figure out how He's going to do it. 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 We serve a great God. We serve a great God. Hallelujah. 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 I turn it over to you, Pastor. We love you today. Pray for me. Pray for me.
Thank you.
Restoration over her right now. Restoration. God, I feel she needs to restore. You know in what area. Everything that the enemy has tried to do to block her, I command it to be loose now in the name of Jesus. Father, you said whatsoever we bind on earth, you would bind in heaven. And whatsoever we loose on earth, will be loosed in earth, will be loosed in heaven. So I speak that she is loose. She is healed in that area. She is delivered. She's set free. Now God give her a peace that passes all she receiving. Give her a peace that passes understanding. Yes, God. If you want to tell me why you can't, tell me. I pray you want to tell me. Yes, God. Now as a point of contact, she came for the son. I touch you right now. When the centurion had a servant there, he had a servant that was about to die. He said, speak the word only, and he shall be made whole. What's his first name? Rodney. I speak to you and I call you in the heavenly realm. I said, angels, I dispatch them right now to the north, south, east, and west. That you would go and get him, that you would save him, deliver him, and turn his life around. I command it to be so in the name of Jesus, and give this mother peace. And Father, put words right now in her mouth that she would prophesy his way back to the house, back to the house of God. Yes, Lord. Just be, he's going to be where he's supposed to be. Amen. You got mustard seed faith this morning. You had faith to walk down. Amen. Come on, somebody. Come on, faith. You have to have faith to love God. Did you know that? You have to have faith to trust. On every occasion, it requires faith. So, Father, I add my faith to my sisters right now. That you would increase her faith. But Father, not only increase her faith, increase her wisdom so that she can gain greater faith. Now God calls her to read books and read the Bible and to study things that she may show herself approved. But I decree and declare right now in the name of Jesus that so great faith has come to her house. Everything that the enemy has been trying to do, I block it off of her mind right now. I decree that her mind is free. Her mind is free. Just lift your hands and receive it. In the name of Jesus. Ah, there it is. Receive it. There it is. Just say, I have the faith of God. Say it like it is. Oh, one more time. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yeah, he's glad you come. You stepped out first. Amen. Amen. You stepped out first. Amen. See, when the waters was trouble, whoever got it first, I wish I had somebody. Huh? Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. The Bible says, they that sow in tears shall reap in joy. I prophesy to you right now that joy is coming today, not in the morning. Because this is what I learned. You can't believe I'm going to get up this morning. I've discovered that it's morning somewhere at any time you speak. So wherever morning is, I'm jumping over there and say that joy comes right now. Now, Father, right now in the name of Jesus, I thank you for allowing her to step over the enemy and step into the promises of God. I decree and declare today that she will never be the same. Never be the same. God, I thank you for breakthrough in her heart, breakthrough in her spirit, and breakthrough in her mind. I thank you for the word of God. Let her know, God. Let her understand today that her love for you, for her, is beyond measure. Beyond measure. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Amen. How many know that when something happened in the Bible, the whole household, they, like if somebody got healed, if the main person believed, he said, I declare salvation for his whole house. So I declare today salvation for your whole house. Amen. Your extended family. So I said, there's a fresh anointing coming up on you today. So see, you got to be bold to come down here with an ulster badge on. Come on, somebody. You got to be bold. That means you don't care what the devil do. You don't care what, you get your miracle, however you got to get it. And God says today, household salvation has come to your house. Yes, he said this. Just like the woman who had the issue of blood. He said this. He said she was whole from that very hour. He said holy. Wholeness means nothing broken. There will be nothing missing. Amen. That's all I want to do. Your family. We're going to pray for these three right here for the family. These three. Would y'all just point your hand towards these three for me, for their families. Father, right now that there's been a link destroyed in this family. But I ask that the Holy Spirit would fill that link right now in the name of Jesus. That you would touch, Lord. Change minds. Change souls. That you would bring your homes and families back together. And Father, if there's anything out of order, I ask that you would reverse it. I destroy every curse that is trying to come upon these three families right now in the name of Jesus. I reverse the curse and I speak, God, a new beginning, restoration for each one of these families. And Father, you said that their steps are ordered. And I decree that today is a new day in Jesus' name. That he's come for increase. Amen. Amen. Increase. Brother Carl, I want you to know that a lot of people want it, but they weren't bold enough to come down here and get it. They want it. They want it, but they weren't bold to get it. God says, today is yours. Hallelujah. All right, he wants to take care of his family, employment to provide for them. But I also feel, in addition to that, I'm going to tell you what God's saying. In addition to you taking care of your family, he's going to provide additional stream of income for you to have your own type of business. Come on, somebody. In addition, if you step out, you want it bad enough. If you lift your hands to receive this. Father, in the name of Jesus, I speak over him right now what you've just spoken to my spirit. Increase for him right now. In the name of Jesus, I call it in from the north, south, east, and west. Father, let his name rise from the bottom of the application to the top. Let whoever he's supposed to work for, God, Father, not get any rest until they make contact with him. And Father, I set up divine appointments for him right now, for his next business opportunity, and that his family and home will be glorious, and that as you give to him, he will obey your word and give tithes and grain offerings. And I prophesy to you that you shall not only give 10%, but you shall give more than 10%. Oh God, he's going to do it for you. Oh God, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. It is done. Let's thank God for these that are coming for us. Let's go. Heaven has given back. Heaven has recorded. God has heard. He's making your request for the name of God. We love you today. We love you. Be blessed. Stay faithful. I don't know if y'all belong to church or not. If you need to get in a good church, make sure you get here. If you're here, get here. Stay faithful. We love you. God bless you. I'll tell you all tonight.
Pastor Adams, a hand, if you will. She's already displayed the blueprint for us this morning as relates to our giving. We now have an opportunity to respond to the word today. So we ask those who are going to help us in this time of giving and receiving, if you would come now and let's demonstrate our obedience to the word today. I just have this is your Senate to give not only your regular offering, but above and beyond offering. We want to invite you to do that today. All right, ushers, would you please come?
Way more than what we expected. We thank you.
program. Now we're going to turn it over to our pastor. So we hope and pray that you all have enjoyed the service, which I know you did. Okay. Thank you.
Amen. That's the church say amen. Amen. Sister? Thank you so much. You know, as I was sitting there, I was thinking in my mind about one of the persons who were down here. And when she started speaking to that person, that person had talked to me on last week about everything that you ministered to them about. I said, wow, the very thing that they were talking to me about is the very thing that she prayed in her prayer, which was the concern of that individual. He spoke into his spirit what he had been asking for. Amen. God moves in mysterious ways. The thing is, his wonders to fulfill. This has been a good day. And Pastor Matt. Now that you have fed us with the two fish and five loaves, we're going to carry you in, I guess, that we'll feed you with 10 loaves and 2 fish. Amen. This has been a beautiful day. Good experience. To those of you who visited with us here today, thank you so much for your presence. There were other places that you could have gone that you did pass, but we praise God that you made this your choice. And to all of our members who are in possibly the church in Oklahoma and the church in Louisiana, the church in Louisiana or the church in Vegas, tell them what good things the Lord has done this day. And I'm praying that as they were there with all of the faith, you know, you go to those churches with faith and hope and expectation and a desire to bring back to this church the tithes and offerings. Again, Giles family, thank you all for being a part of our fellowship and our worship today. Sister Patty, good to see you here today. And all of you here today, dinner is going to be served over in our fellowship hall. And we would hope that you would come and share with us, because Texas Land and Cattle, Papados, and all those other days cannot give you the sumptuous, scrumptious, succulent, delicious, watering food that our brothers are over there fixing now. Candied yams, collard greens, ribs and links, steak, all of that kind of stuff is over there. And we want you to come and be filled and be blessed. And so before we go, let me just offer the thanks for the meal. Eternal God, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the sister who has come to share with us. We thank you for the Giles family, Lord. And we pray your grace, your mercy, your tender love upon them, that we might see many more days and praise you and give you the glory. And now we pray for each and every one here today and ask your grace upon them. And now we give thanks unto thee that which we are about to receive for the nourishing and the fellowship one with the other. In Jesus' name, amen. Our fellowship hall is on this side.